Hello! It's good to see you today as well. The last time we learned that God's word is complete. Today we're going to learn that God's word should not be changed. My name is Uncle Nana, and Auntie Hadi will be teaching about that story, or that word or lesson from the Bible. Before we do that, let's recap our memory verse, the memory verse that we've been doing the past few weeks. And it's 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. All right? Let's see if you remember it. You've been doing it all these weeks. Tell me. Let me hear you. Yes. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. And all scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness. Yes, that the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. All right. Amen. Let's say it again. One more time. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. Let's say it together. All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. Wonderful. So before we get into the word, let's pray. Lord Jesus, we're so grateful that you brought us all together to listen to your word. Help us listen carefully so that we'll be able to do exactly what you want us to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness. That the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. That the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work.
All scripture is breathed out by
and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness.
I'll be right back.
This one here. And I would fix this one here. Yes. I think this fits quite right. I think I'm going to share an important lesson with Uncle Nana when he comes back from a snack break. Hello, Uncle Nana.
Ah, what's happening here? You fit the wrong puzzles.
I fixed your puzzle for you.
No, it Why? Doesn't fit right.
It does.
No.
Fits perfectly.
No, it's not a flower puzzle.
But it fits perfectly.
No,
it's complete.
It's not.
Nothing has changed.
I just picked up a snack and I came back and look at what you've done. No, it's
but
not
it
a flower
fits,
puzzle.
But it fits perfectly. Doesn't it look nice? It's the same. Nothing has changed.
No, it's look a flower. All it's not the a edges. Flower puzzle.
It fits in perfectly. Well, Uncle Nana, I intentionally did this so that we could share an important lesson from God's word, which tells us that we should not change God's word.
Oh.
Yes. Do you want to listen?
Yes.
Well, please join me and let's share the lesson together.
Okay.
So, just like we see in this puzzle here, which you've started very beautifully, some people do not really like the Bible like we do, you know? Some people don't believe in the Bible, and they try to change it. They try to add new things and even take some out. They try to add their own ideas. They try to say things that are different from what God originally meant the Bible to be. Just like we have here in the puzzle.
Okay.
You see, all the other parts that I put in fits perfectly, doesn't it?
Yeah, it fits quite right.
And it looks complete, doesn't it?
Yeah, it seems complete.
Exactly. You know, there are some people who think that the Bible can be changed. They can change God's word to suit what they want. Yes, and once we do that, there's a verse in Deuteronomy that tells us that God doesn't like that. God doesn't want us to change anything in his word, whether from the Old Testament or from the New Testament. God's word should not be changed. I want us to look at that verse in Deuteronomy. It tells us two things that we should not do to change God's word. It says that, do not take anything out of God's word or add anything to his word. Yes, Uncle Nana. Yes.
Okay.
And so God says that if we do that, he's going to punish anybody, who adds or takes anything out from his holy word. Isn't that scary?
Yeah. I don't want to do that. No.
No. The same way, just as this puzzle can fit together perfectly, those who try to change God's word also try to do that in the same way, just so that we will think it is true. And God tells us that he does not like that. In fact, he says he's going to punish anybody who adds to his word or changes it. God's word is complete. God's word should not be changed. Uncle Nana, do you know that the Bible says anybody who changes God's word is called a false teacher? Yes, a false teacher is anybody who tries to change what the Bible has said and even adds new things to the Bible. God has finished writing his word through his prophets, through all the people that he spoke to, and they heard it and they saw everything that happened. So God is not happy about it when we try to change his word. He calls such people false teachers. Now, we're going to go through some questions to test us to see whether we'll be able to identify whether these are true or false. Uncle Nana, are you ready?
Yes, I am.
All right. So let's go on with the first question. I'm sure you're ready.
Let's play a true or false game. I'm going to say some things you might have heard, and I want you to tell me if they are true or false. I think you're ready. Here's the first one. Jesus is the only way to heaven. Is this true or false? You're right. It's true that Jesus is the only way to heaven. That's what the Bible tells us. Good. How about this? What if I say the Bible has mistakes in it? Is that also true or false? Does the Bible have mistakes in it? Is that true or false? That's definitely false. The Bible has no mistakes in it. It is complete, and no one can change the word of God. Good. Let's do the next one. God created Adam and Eve. Is this true or false? Did God create Adam and Eve? You are right. God created Adam and Eve. He created them male and female. You are right on that one. Good job. Let's look at the next one. The true gospel is about Jesus only. The true gospel is about Jesus only. Is that true or false? That is true. The Bible tells us that Jesus is the only way to heaven, and that gives us information about the gospel. What about this? God will bless those who preach a false gospel. Is that true or false? Will God bless those who preach a false gospel? You're right. This is false. God is not happy when we preach a false gospel. And the Bible says that He will punish those who do that. Let's look at the last one. God created the heavens and the earth. Is this true or false? Yes, that's true. God created the heavens and the earth. And the Bible tells us that God did this in 6 days. Well done. Good job. Remember that we cannot change God's word. We cannot add to it. Neither should we take anything out. God's word cannot be destroyed.
I'm sure you're able to get most of the questions correct. All right, so Uncle Nana, now we've learned that we should not add anything to God's word, neither should we take anything out. If we do that, what will God do? He will punish us. Uncle Nana, I think you can complete the right puzzle.
All right.
The right pieces to fit it all together and make it complete, just like God's word. Okay. Go ahead.
So we'll do away with this puzzle.
Okay.
This piece too, they look quite right, but they are not right.
Correct.
This is the right puzzle. This is the right piece here. And the last piece. Wow.
Wow.
And these pieces fit perfectly together. Excellent.
Beautiful. So I think I can do away with these ones since they don't fit together. All right. So friends, what have we learned today? Two things for us to remember. God's word is true. It cannot be changed. God doesn't want us to add anything or take anything out. There's going to be a picture that will pop up on the screen, and you can see what this man is doing. What do you think he's doing? He's holding a scissors. I'm sure you can see that. He's holding a pen. What's he trying to do? Can you guess? We can see that he stuck some sheets of paper in the Bible. And we can see that he's taking some papers out too. I'm sure you can notice that. That's what some people try to do to God's word. They take out the portions that they don't like, and they even try to add some things to God's word. And remember what we said, God does not want us to do that. So friends, when you go to school, when you are with your friends, wherever you are, when someone tries to tell you things that are not true, things that are not what the Bible says we should do, remember that God expects you to say the right thing as you have been taught, as you have read yourself, and as you have heard at church or at Sunday school, mm-hmm. or from your parents, or from any adult person who has told you the truth from God's word. So, if you haven't yet read the Bible before, if you have not made Jesus your special friend, if you don't even have a Bible, you don't know what is inside, but you would like to have a Bible, you would like to make Jesus your friend, you'd like to know what the Bible talks about, you can just pray right now with us. And Jesus will be your special friend. Jesus will come into your heart and will help you to understand everything in the Bible, so that you too can believe it, and you will not believe what the false teachers will say. Mm. Uncle Nana, can you please pray with our friends who are ready to make Jesus their special friend?
Yes, sure. So friends, let's pray. And please pray after me. Say this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, today, come into my heart. Help me to stop all the naughty things I've done. Please make me your special friend, so that when you come, I'll be with you also. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hooray. So if you said this prayer, you have become Jesus' friend, would like for you to get a Bible and read it and get to know more about Jesus and what the Bible tells us. Until we meet again. Bye.
Hello, my dear friends. It's now time for craft after your wonderful lesson that you learned today. Today we learned that we should not change God's word, because God's word is complete. So for our craft, we are going to do our own puzzle. Can you imagine? I think you have puzzles in the house and you've done puzzles before. But today, we are going to learn how to do our own puzzle, okay? So for this craft, I have a foam sheet, I have manila cards, I have a marker, pen, a small brush to take the glue, and then scissors to do some cutting. And I'm using this as my ruler. You can also find your own ruler, okay? All right, so let's start. So these sheets, I've cut them into two, and I'm going to stick them together. But before I do that, I want to write on it my puzzle. So I'll create the space where the words of the puzzle will fit. Okay, I'm done with that. Then I take my scissors. I'm going to cut out this square so that that will be the place where I'll put the words or the puzzle. So I'm cutting it out gently. If you can't handle the scissors, you have to let mommy or daddy do the cutting out for you, okay? All right. So I cut it out. Last lap to cut. Cut it out nicely. Okay, so this is out, and we get this, and I put it on. And then I need to glue this so that when I do the puzzle, this is where we'll fit the puzzle. So this is the glue, and I'm using a brush to take the glue. Oh, I want it to dry fast, so I'll just take small glue and glue the sides. Let's glue the sides. So this is my own puzzle. And you can do your own puzzles in the house. In fact, you can do some as birthday presents for your friends and your family. See, after that, I put the one I cut out on it. So it now becomes just one sheet. Okay, good. Now, let's put that aside. Whilst it is drying, then we do our puzzle. So this size is what will fit here. But if I put this blue inside, maybe we cannot really see. So just for the sake of this craft, I'll cut it out on a yellow manila, which I'll fit into it. So I draw it on the card. But you can also use the same thing and write on it and cut it out. So this is what is going to fit into our puzzle card. Cut it out quickly. Almost done. I'm almost there. We want to remember that God's word is complete, and so we should not change anything. We should not take anything out of it, and we should not add anything to it. God's word is complete. Okay. So this will be fitting into our puzzle here. Now, what is our puzzle? What I'm going to, you can actually draw something on it and color it, and then you cut it out. You can write, you can do anything, or put a picture and paste it here. But I'm just going to write there, don't change God's word, just like the lesson we learned, okay? So I'm going to write it boldly. Write the apostle, don't, apostrophe. Don't change God's word. I just want to have it bold, so I'm kind of writing over it again. It would be nice to print a picture, and you know how puzzles are. It could be a picture of a playground, of a tree, of animals, a picture of your class, maybe when you were playing. You can use that as your puzzle. All right. So this is what I have written. Now I'll turn the back of the paper and I'll draw some lines. 2. I'm just drawing my lines across the back of the paper. And then I'll draw another one across it again. Good. When I finish, I'm going to number it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that it will be easy to follow when I'm doing my puzzle. And after that, I cut through the exact lines I have made. Okay? I'm cutting through the lines to create my puzzle. You know, puzzles are made up of so many little pieces. Just like the Bible has how many books? 66 books. And Genesis, from Genesis you go to what? Exodus. So I have numbered this according to the numbers. So my puzzle is only 8 pieces. You can do as many pieces as you want. You can do 12, 20. So when you look at it, it's all mixed up. Okay. Now let's put it all on the side here and bring our puzzle that we are going to fit it in. If you start by picking it from here, it becomes difficult. So let's just turn the back and look for the numbers and start putting the numbers down. Okay, this is 1. How will 1 fit? Don't I put it here? Okay, let's see. Where is number 2? Where is the puzzle? The puzzle, where is number 2? Oh, 2 is here. How will 2 fit? Okay, sorry, 1 is here. 2. Good. Where's 3? Okay. 3 fits here. You see how our puzzle is coming up? Where is 4? 4 is here. Okay, 4 goes into the corner. Oh, we are almost doing the full puzzle. Where's 5? I look for 5. How does 5 fit? Okay. It fits here. Okay, my 6 is here. 6. Don't change God's word. How does it fit? How does it fit? Yes. And now we have 7. 7 fits here. Oh! Look at that. Don't change God's word. But imagine that whilst I'm doing the puzzle, I decide that this puzzle, I won't even put this there. Let me go and take another puzzle's own and come and put it inside. Then I come and put one here. It doesn't even fit. Okay, let me try another one from a different puzzle. I don't care. I just want to put a different puzzle there. I can't seem to fit it there, you see. So the thing is that we cannot change God's word. We cannot go and take some of God's word out and then go and bring another thing and come and put it in. We have changed it. And God says his word is complete. We shouldn't change anything. So these, when I tried it, they didn't work. They don't fit the puzzle. It means that, the word of God is complete. Everything I need to know is there. So I will stick to the word of God and put the puzzle right back here. Good. And I can even package this, put it in an envelope and give it to somebody. Okay? So our craft today is don't change God's word. You can do this puzzle at home. It's very simple. Find a picture, or you can write, or you can draw, and then you cut it out, number it at the back, and then try and fit it in by yourself. You can play it with your friends. Okay? All right. Thank you for joining Craft Time. God bless you. Have a good week, my best friend. See you next time. Bye.